And you have to put a lot of your time, mm-hmm. give of yourself a lot.
Do you feel, I talked to Suzanne DePass the other day, and Suzanne DePass worked with you all for a long time at Motown and really groomed you all and found the outfits for the Ed Sullivan show. And Suzanne had some interesting theories about your childhood. We talked about whether or not it was really lost. Was it?
Well, especially now, I come to realize, and then, I would do my schooling, which was 3 hours with a tutor. Then mm-hmm. right after that, you know, I'd go to the recording studio and record. And I'd record for hours and hours till it was time to go to sleep. So it'd be nighttime. And I remember going to the recording studio. There was a park across the street, and I'd see all the children playing, and they'd be rooting and making noise, and I would cry. It'd make me sad that I would have to go and work instead.
I wanted to go to this to hear what Suzanne had to say about your childhood.
Sure.
And we're going to look at some pictures of you as a little boy.
Okay.
Describe a performance. Describe the performance that you put on.
What I do?
Yeah.
Well, most of my songs are fast.
I mean, what do you put into it?
Well, whenever I sing, that's what I really mean. When, like, I'm singing a song. I don't sing it if I don't mean it.
I met Michael Jackson. He was 9 years old, going on 10. And he was a little boy in many ways. And then he'd go out on stage and be this dynamic superstar.
With a child's heart, go face the worries of the day.
He lost the ability to be a kid before his 12th birthday. Michael Jackson really was never able to go anywhere without a bodyguard or without a limousine or without, you know, people to protect him from his success.
No need to worry.
To not ever be able to just go out to the park and look up at the sky and to not be able to go to the movies, I just think that he has paid a tremendous price.
Said it was a heavy price. I want to know how big of a price it was, losing your childhood or having this kind of life.
Well, you don't get to do things that other children get to do. You know, the simple things that they so much take for granted.
Mm-hmm.
Having friends and slumber parties and buddies and just hanging out. There was none of that for me. I didn't have any friends when I was little. My brothers were my friends.
Was there ever a place where, because, you know, children, you know, I remember playing games and talking to myself and playing with my dolls and all that. Was there, and I think every child needs a place to escape into a child's world, into a child's imagination. Was there ever a time you could do that?
No, and that is why I think now, because I didn't have it then, I compensate for that.
Really?
I mean, people wonder why I always have children around, because I find the thing that I never had through them, you know, Disneyland, amusement parks, mm-hmm. Arcade games. I adore all that stuff because when I was little, it was always work, 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 from one concert to the next. If it wasn't concert, it was the recording studio. If it wasn't that, it was TV shows or interviews or picture sessions.
Mm-hmm.
It was always something to do.
Did you feel, Smokey Robinson has said this about you, and so have many other people, that you were like an old soul in a little body?
When I remember hearing that all the time when I was little. They used to call me a 45-year-old midget wherever I went.
Mm-hmm.
I used to always hear that, and I just would hear it, and I never thought about it. Just like when some people say, when you were little and you started to sing, did you know you were that good? I never thought about it. I just did it, and it came out. I never thought about it, really.
So here you were, Michael Jackson, with hits. You all had so many hits. Four hits in a row, and you were crying because you couldn't be like other kids.
Well, I love show business, mm-hmm. and I still love show business, but then there are times you want to play and have some fun, and that part did make me sad. I remember one time we were getting ready to go to South America, and everybody was packed up in the cars, ready to leave and go, and the plane was about to, and I hid, And I was crying while I was hiding because I really did not want to go. I wanted to play. I did not want to go.
Were your brothers jealous of you when you started getting all the attention?
Not that I know of, mm-hmm. No.
You never felt a sense of jealousy?
Let me think. No.
No?
No, I think they were always happy for me that I could do certain things, you know, and but I've never felt jealousy among them, no.
Do you feel that they're jealous of you now?
I wouldn't think so. I don't think so, no.
No? What's your relationship like with your family? Are you all close still?
I love my family very much. I wish I could see them a little more often than I do. But we understand because we're a show business family and we all work.
Mm-hmm.
We do have family day when we all get together. We'll pick a person's house. It might be Jermaine's house or Marlon's house or Tito's house. And everybody will come together and we'll fellowship and love each other and talk and catch up on who's doing what. And you know.
You all aren't all upset about LaToya and LaToya's book and the things that LaToya has said about the family?
Well, I haven't read LaToya's book.
Uh-huh.
I just know I love my sister dearly. I love LaToya, and I always will. And I always see her as the happy, loving LaToya that I remember mm-hmm. growing up with. So I couldn't completely answer on that.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that some of the things that she's been saying are true?
I couldn't answer, Oprah. Honestly, mm-hmm. I haven't read the book. That's the honest truth.
Mm-hmm. So let's go back to when you were growing up and feeling all of this. Well, I guess it's a sense of anguish, I guess. So there was nobody for you to play with other than your brothers. You never had slumber parties. You never?
Never.
Never?
No.
So I'm wondering for you, being this cute little boy that everybody adored and everybody who comes up to you, they're, you know, pulling your cheeks and how cute, and this child prodigy, really, how adolescence affected you? Because I call, you know, adolescence going through that duck stage where everything's awkward, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm wondering if when you started to go through adolescence, having been, you know, this child superstar,
yes.
did that have a, was that a particularly difficult time for you?
Very, very, very difficult. Really? Yes.
Yes.
Because how so? I think every child star suffers through this period because you're not the cute and charming mm-hmm. child that you were and you start to grow. And they want to keep you young forever and little forever.
Who's they?
The public.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, nature takes its course.
Mm-hmm.
And
it does.
And I had pimples so badly, and it made me so shy. I used to not look at myself. I'd wash my face in the dark. I wouldn't want to look in the mirror.
Really?
And my father teased me. And I just hated it. I cried every day because of it.
Your father would tease you about your
yes,
pimples?
Yes, he would tell me I'm ugly.
Your father would say
yes,
that?
He would. Sorry, Joseph.
Yeah. What's your relationship like with him?
I love my father, but I don't know him.
Mm-hmm. Are you angry with him for doing that? I think that's pretty cruel, actually.
Am I angry with him?
Because adolescence is hard enough without a parent
difficult.
Telling you that you're ugly.
Yeah, it's very difficult.
Uh-huh.
Am I angry with him? Sometime I do get angry, yes. I don't know him the way I'd like to know him. My mother's wonderful. To me, mm-hmm. she's perfection. I just wish I could understand my father.
And so let's talk about these teen years. What is that when you started to go inside yourself? Because obviously you haven't spoken to to the world for, you know, 14 years, I think, is your last televised interview. So you went inside, you became a recluse, and that was on purpose. Was it to protect yourself?
I felt that there wasn't anything important for me to say. And those were very sad, sad years for me. And
why so sad? Because on stage we see you performing, you're getting your Grammys. Why so sad?
Oh, there's a lot of sadness about my past life and, you know, adolescence and my father and all of those things. It just made me very, very, very sad.
So he would tease you, make fun of you?
Yes.
Did he ever beat you?
Yes.
He did.
Yes.
And that was difficult to take, getting beaten and going on stage and performing.
Yes.
And why would he beat you?